So my name's Tom Cech. I'm the co-director of the One World, One Water Center here at Metropolitan State University in Denver. We were created about 5 years ago to do three things here on the campus. We created a water studies minor and a water studies certificate for any academic major at the university. Why have a water exhibit in an art gallery? Which is a great question, and it's a wonderful direction to go with water awareness. The first step of changing public policy or affecting public policy in water, such as our state water plan, is awareness. If the general public has no really awareness of where their water comes from or what the local issues are or how they can make a difference, it's really difficult to then get involved in the next level, which is policy, public policy toward water. You know, should the city of Denver and Denver Water have policies toward the use of water in a homeowners association? Should there be kind of voluntary or mandatory restrictions on water use? And those are really touchy topics for lots of people. And if there isn't a level of awareness on basic water information, water usage, where the water comes from, it's hard to get involved in those conversations about larger policy issues. So art is a wonderful way to get an awareness growing at a local level with the individual to where they want to learn more about their water sources, their water supply, and water policy in the future. It could be done through history. It could be done through an English literature program. Art is one of many avenues to engage people to want to learn more and get more involved in public policy with water and water awareness and water stewardship. Well, the next step then is to look in your community, your neighborhood, such as your HOA, your homeowners association, if you belong to one. Or maybe you have a neighborhood group that looks at ways to be better stewards from a climate standpoint, from an environmental standpoint. Anything you can do with local parks, maybe with reducing water usage in a neighborhood park or in a HOA situation. Those are places to broaden your impact as a water steward beyond just your house inside and out. Then the next place to look is to look at nonprofit organizations or organizations that are looking for volunteers. What can you do with a local conservation group or a groundwater protection group, or maybe it's a surface water protection group picking up trash along a stream? What can you do in the broader community to bring awareness to water usage, to picking up trash, to improve water quality and things of that nature, to where you're broadening your impact? Then a next step beyond that is maybe to look into joining a board of directors of a water organization, your local water provider. Maybe there's places there where you can get involved, again, for more awareness, to help in the decision-making process. It's kind of a step process. You start with yourself in your home, work your way up to the neighborhood, then perhaps with nonprofit organizations that can always use help, and then look at your water provider or other water organizations in your community where you can perhaps even have a stronger impact in terms of helping direct public policy or how budgets are spent on water conservation or water protection and water stewardship.